the dates.
We're going to start again.
What is up?
What's up, guys? Episode 7 underway. And we're trying to do a different kind of a video here. We're trying to... this is basically after the session, we just want to sit down and talk about how the session went. I think this gives us enough time to, you know, talk about how we were feeling throughout the entire workout and explain to you every exercise and every variation that we tried to do during the workout. So today was a leg day and we've changed the split for the second week. Keep things exciting and in this split what we're trying to do is keep two compound exercises to start off with. It was lower body today, so the two compound lifts that we chose were deadlifts and squats. So for the deadlifts
we did, if you remember last week, for deadlifts for every compound movement we did 5 sets of 5 at the rate 80%. So to use progressive overload and to, you know, use periodization, we used five. We did the same thing. We did 80% of our 1 rep max, but this time we did for 5 sets of 7 reps. So increasing the volume as we went up, and the weight was the same since it was 80% of your 1 rep max.
Squats. So for squats, we didn't keep the same reps and sets for that. What we did was we kept it slightly lighter, which was 75%.
70%.
We did that for 1 rep max, and we did that for 4 sets of 8 reps.
And we followed our tempo.
And mind you, we kept it continuous. We didn't take a break between every rep, if you see. And what that did was basically kept time under tension and kept the tension in your quads, which you want to keep. If you're doing 8 reps, if you do 3 sets of 3 or 5 or 3 to 5, which is you're basically concentrating on strength, then you should take a deep breath between every single rep and make sure you brace your core before every single rep. But here what we did was we kept the tension, and that's what you want to feel while doing a higher rep range. After these two compound lifts, it was really taxing. What we did after that was leg press, right?
Yeah, we moved on to a superset of leg press and stiff leg deadlifts. So again, working the quads and working the hamstrings.
So here, what we did was it was a tempo that we kept, and again, time under tension. So what we did was we took two counts on the leg press. We took two counts to bring it down, held it for two seconds, and then brought it back up for two as well.
And we did the same for stiff leg deadlifts as well. We did this for 3 sets of 8 reps. And
but
it'll feel like an eternity, like while you're doing the exercises, like it'll feel like an eternity getting this thing down for 2 counts, holding it for 2 counts and pushing it back up in a controlled manner as well.
For the last 2 sets of the stiff leg deadlift, we got it back up in 1 count, because after doing deadlift you will feel your lower back. So if you do feel your lower back, get it up in 1 count, that's fine, keep it a little explosive. But make sure you're feeling the stretch and the contraction in your hamstrings, because that's what the exercise is for, and make sure you do that. next one was my favorite and his worst, the walking lunges, weighted walking lunges. If your gym is long enough, do it for the length of your gym, set three sets. And if your gym is not long enough, do a standing and make sure you get at least 10 to 12 reps on each leg. What we did here, we focused on basically keeping our weight on the front leg. Make sure your knee doesn't spill over, and you make sure that doesn't happen by keeping your core tight. Push through your heels of the front foot. Make sure the entire tension is on your front foot, on your front quad. It will also contract your work your glutes and your bit of your hamstrings as well. Take a slightly wider step when you're taking it. Take it outside of your body so that you're targeting your inner quads for this. There are variations to obviously target your outer quad as well. But what we did here was take a step out, if you notice.
If you see the previous like lunges videos and stuff, we always go like while lunging, we always go straight down. But if you see like in the clip that's gonna come, this session we try to variate that as well. I didn't take as long steps as I would. Obviously, I went out of my body, but I didn't take longer steps. And what we were doing is focusing on shifting the weight a little more towards your the front leg. So if you're lunging down, the front leg that you're stepping out on, shifting the weight slightly, so you're not your body's not going straight down, but you're going slightly forward, and at the same time you're not bending, like your knee's not crossing as well, let it cut. At the same time you're not letting your knee to go past your toes. So this is again like we're trying a few variations, and you can try it as well, and let us know how you felt about this variation in the comments down below.
We ended this session with
calf raises.
What?
Calf raises.
Calf raises. Alright, so yeah, we've got not much footage of this, but
calves, not much.
But what you need to do for this is, you know, feel like there's just very, very few things to keep in mind when you're doing your calves. Keep the entire range of motion, get your head in it, and do the fucking exercise. Like, that's all you've got to do. Like, we neglected it for a very long time, but now we're getting our head down, getting it done. Even if it's after your session, even if you're feeling tired, just make sure
At the same time, while doing calf raises, we don't have like a calf raise machine or a standing calf raise, seated calf raise machine. So what we do is we do it on the leg press machine. So if you do have one machine in the gym, make sure you do it on that. If a seated calf raise machine is very good. And if you're doing it on the leg press, try to keep a slight bend in your knees. Don't keep your knees fully extended, fully straight. Try to keep a slight bend in your knees, as you will see in the footage. And that'll help to really contract your soleus. And
we'll be doing it for the second time in the week as well. We're splitting legs into two halves. Yeah. And what we want to tell you is that we will be using a lot of variation in our leg exercises. So make sure to see the next leg day as well.
But this session for calf raises, we did 5 sets of 10 reps. So we kept the weight moderately heavy. For calves, I don't go too heavy because I just don't feel safe in my ankles and stuff. So I like to keep the weight as light as possible, but at the same time we got like 10 reps and it was all about like getting a good stretch, getting a good contraction, yeah, and then holding it at the top as well. So focus on the eccentric, concentric and the isometric hold as well.
Weight doesn't really matter here, make sure you feel the contraction on every single rep.
Weight doesn't matter or anything, you have to make sure how much you get done with the weight matters.
And you want to talk about rest days? We got a comment as well.
One important thing like throughout this program is rest days. Like we've been asked like, you know, how many days of rest are you taking? Are you going to, is this episode 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, everything back to back? No, it's not. Basically, after the third session, we took a 2 days rest. And then we got back to the fourth session, which was abs. And then metabolic conditioning. And then since then, we've been going back to back. But it depends on how you're feeling, how your body is adapting. If after the second session, you want to take a day off, feel free. If after the third, you want to take a day off, feel free. It's completely entirely.
We had one late night as well. We probably, ek do baj gaya tha. So what we did was, it was a little late. So we didn't basically get up on time for gym. And we thought that we might as well take a rest day for that. We got some work done at home. And we just hit it hard the next day. So if your social life does come into your routine, just don't let it hinder it. Just get back onto the routine the next day. Doesn't mean that if you have a rest day which was not accounted for, doesn't mean that you just stop doing the entire thing. Get back onto it. Yeah,
But that's when making plans realistic comes into play. You don't keep like the way we plan it is we always keep like a couple of days of buffer where we know that exactly. something or the other might go wrong. Some family stuff might come up or you might have to do something. So it's, and that's what, this is a lifestyle as well. Like, this is not a profession. Like, obviously we are into it.
But you are also things outside of this as well.
Exactly. So, yeah. And for most of you are watching, you'll have a life. You're probably going to office. You're probably going to university, whatever.
So you have
got to work around it. Yeah. So that's pretty much it. And if you like this video, please like the goddamn video. Don't forget to share it with your friends. Subscribe to the channel for more videos. Yeah, so there'll be 75 workout videos, probably not 90.
Make sure
regular uploads will be coming from us. We do keep up on Instagram and stuff, so we do make, and we do make blog posts as well. So do follow that on our website.
And also, if you have any kind of feedback, any kind of comments you want to tell us about,
any questions,
please feel free to contact us on any kind of social media that you see us on.
And
it gives us an idea of how we are doing. Even if you're helping even one person out there, it just makes us feel really, really good. Concluding episode 7. See you in the 8th episode.
Cut it!
Cut it.